We have something that's more special than anything that any school can offer. And it's that building over there, the Pit.
Hello, once again, Lobo fans. We're back on the Bob King Court inside the legendary Pit. We're a mile high and 37 feet below with new men's basketball coach at UNM, Richard Pitino. I'm your host, Robert Portnoy. Episode 3 is rapid fire, Coach Pitino. Have you done anything like this before?
Many times, probably too often. So it's, but it's fun. I'm excited to do it.
All right, let's do it. We're going to start with this. Have you ever played any musical instruments?
I have. Funny story, actually. My piano teacher, when I was in Lexington, Kentucky, is the brother of Jim Boeheim's wife. So that's a small world. And they met, actually, she's from Lexington. And so a small world. So I am not a good piano player anymore. I did learn the theme to Forrest Gump that my mom tries to get me to play. And I'm like, Mom, that was like 25 years ago, maybe 30 years ago. I don't remember it anymore. But small world with the Jim Boeheim connection.
So it was always the piano, though.
Always the piano, nothing else, no. My daughter's into the recorder right now, which that should be banned from every school in the country. So hopefully New Mexico doesn't have recorders. We may pick a school solely on if they don't have recorders.
I've always thanked my lucky stars that my kids never took up the drums.
Oh, no doubt. Yeah, they're not allowed to in our house.
All right, rapid fire continues. Any pets growing up?
I did have a pet growing up in Boston. His name was Cosmo, so I am a huge Seinfeld fan. And we named him after Cosmo Kramer.
Giddy up, all right.
So yes, we had a pet Cosmo. And then unfortunately, I had a dog pass away recently named Bernie after Bernie Williams, a Yankee player. And just got a dog in COVID named Hank. So named him Hank after Bernie's original name was Hank, so we named him after Hank.
Where were you when you watched the Yankees win their first championship that you can remember?
Had to be in Kentucky. Yeah, had to be in Kentucky. And we went to a couple playoff games that year. Actually had a great opportunity one time to play golf with Derek Jeter. That was like the coolest thing ever. And he's as cool of a guy as you would think. But I've never met Bernie Williams. I want to meet Bernie Williams. He's always, they had so many great players on that roster, but Bernie was always my guy.
Okay, so that leads us right into the next one, and you might have just answered it. Your favorite athlete all time, and why?
Michael Jordan. Just, you know, for our era, you know, the one thing that I love doing is arguing players, current players, about who's better, LeBron. It's so much recency bias, but for me, Michael Jordan growing up, just, you know, one of the coolest moments ever. My dad was a Celtic coach. First game in the Boston Garden, they beat the Bulls right after they won the championship, but just in awe of him. And obviously the Last Dance, that documentary, just showed even more just what a fierce competitor, a winner, was all about winning. And so, you know, I would say Michael Jordan growing up.
I gotta mix this one in. A memory from childhood, first one that you can remember, or a really big one, being in an arena when you were a young kid watching one of your dad's teams.
Horrible moment, 1992, Christian Laettner. That was really one of my first vivid memories of college basketball. And I remember it being an unbelievable game. I can't believe I got into coaching because that shot went in and I still went back. But yeah, Christian Laettner, 1992 was my first memory.
Okay, what about high school extracurricular activities? Did you have any?
Not really, you know, I mean, it was more, you know, hanging out with friends. And I always was around, whether it was me playing basketball or the Celtics. I would legitimately finish practice, and then if I could go to practice, I'd drive down to the facility. So I was around it so much. I was really ingrained in every team, whether it was my own team or his team. You know, and then hanging out with friends. I mean, when you grow up in Boston, it's a lot of sitting around making fun of each other. That's kind of the way it is, and laughing and joking. So no, those two things, you know, but just being around basketball as much as I could.
Did Coach ever have you on the seat next to him in the bus? Do you remember that?
Oh, for sure. For sure. And, you know, every year I try to, there's a great footage of, I brought Jack at Purdue one game, and Purdue is like the Pit. It's a tough place to play. And all of a sudden in the middle of the game, I get a tap on the shoulder that he's got to go to the bathroom, and they caught it on camera. So it's a funny clip for Lobo fans to see.
That's great. We're doing rapid fire with Richard Pitino, the new men's basketball coach at the University of New Mexico. Do you have a favorite color?
Green.
Green. That's going to change, right?
Yeah. Well, it's funny how that all works. I mean, it's you change these schools, you know, you had red. I had so many Louisville stuff, and then I got rid of those ties. So I'm going to text my dad and say, hey, you can have my maroon ties. I want your red ties. You know, so certainly that. But it's
Celtic green, isn't it?
Celtic green, luck. I always think of luck. I think my eyes might be a little bit green as well. But, you know, it's going to have to be red now moving forward.
Okay. What about a favorite food?
I love pizza. I love pizza. I mean, that's kind of my one, like, after the game. I love it. You can't have too much of it, but I love it.
Okay. And I got to ask this because you're in New Mexico now. We spell chili with an E. That's green chili or red chili. Have you had a burrito or something like that with green or red on it yet? Do you have a preference?
I think both. Christmas, as they say. I like them both. And I've gotten an opportunity to go out a couple times. I mean, the food here is unbelievable. I'm going to have some self-discipline, you know, because it's you can get you can go down a rabbit hole quickly at some of these restaurants. But I'll say, you know, green and red for sure.
All right. So Christmas, we like that. I tell you what, it doesn't take long. I've put green chili on pretty much everything now. You'll get assimilated very quickly.
I have been. And it's unique and it's awesome. And it's just a special, special place that they're so proud of that the food, and it's cool to be a part of.
Okay. What about when you need to decompress? Do you have something, a stress reliever? What do you do?
I like to work out. Yeah, I mean, obviously get a sweat in. I think it's very important for coaches or anybody who's in a high-pressure situation. You have to do that, get your mind off it a little bit. I love watching, you know, like I said, I love watching comedies, you know, Netflix, go to a movie. You know, I would, I don't know where the movie theater is here, but every now and then I'll sneak out of that office, go see a movie by myself. I love to do that as well.
Fantastic. Well, you just mentioned Netflix. Obviously with COVID, even a maniacal coach has a little downtime. What have you recently binged, or what have you binged over this last year as we've kind of been shut up a little bit?
Yeah, we binged a bunch when COVID hit. I thought that the most recent one was Queen's Gambit. I thought that was awesome. Just so well done. It's amazing now what's come on TV. Some of these series are just amazing. You know, coincidentally, I'd say my favorite show was Breaking Bad for sure. Not even saying that because of Albuquerque. I mean, it's one of the most well-made shows. I always say Breaking Bad, The Sopranos, and then if you want to go comedy, you got to go Seinfeld, Curb Your Enthusiasm.
Curb Your Enthusiasm. Well, see, I was going to ask you, since you mentioned Seinfeld, there's so many good new comedies. Have you found a new one that kind of holds up the standard that you love to watch?
Well, nothing to the level of that.
Okay.
I mean, those are absolute game changers. I think Brooklyn Nine-Nine is pretty funny. I like that. My wife and I love that. I mean, it's an easy watch. Arrested Development back in the day was another great one. So I haven't found any great comedies yet. But certainly the Netflix series are just amazing.
All right, harder one. Was there a show that Jill convinced you to watch that you weren't really like, I don't know, but then it turned out to be great?
Queen's Gambit. Yeah, Queen's Gambit. I'm like chess. I don't really like chess. I don't know how to play chess. But she convinced me of that, and it was one of the best ones I've watched in years.
Okay, this is the final one. We want to get this place absolutely packed to the rafters again. What is your idea? What is your thought? What is your vision about how to pack the pit once again and make it like what you remember from back when you were here the first time in 85?
Yeah, I would say that style of play has got to be something where Lobo fans, you know, I can just tell after being here for a week, there's a sense of pride in the state of New Mexico, and there's a sense of pride in this basketball program. You got to represent yourself the right way every single day in the community. Whether it's me, my staff, my players, anybody that's associated with Lobo basketball needs to do that. Then when they walk on the court, you better understand that you're playing for all the people in this arena. You're playing for all the people in this state. It's not about you. It's about New Mexico. Everything that we do is about New Mexico. And when you watch us play, you say, wow, they play really hard. They may not be perfect. And that's okay. You're not going to be perfect in basketball, but they are leaving everything on the court. So representing yourself the right way on and off the court, playing a fun style of basketball, but making sure that you don't take for granted any person that buys a ticket to watch us play, we appreciate. And the more and more people that come in here, we got to make this place impossible to play, because there's not that many venues like this in college basketball.
You've definitely done rapid fire before because that was really good. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, Richard Pitino, the new men's basketball coach at the University of Mexico. That's the final episode of A Mile High and 37 Feet Below, presented by Bud Light. I'm your host, Robert Portnoy. Thanks, everybody. Go Lobos.